Hey everybody, welcome to the answer session of Ask Dr. Dan. This week's subject was bioidentical hormone replacement therapy. Thanks again for all the questions. And if any of your questions are not answered today, I will answer you back personally. And if you have any other questions after this, you can write to us on any of our social media and I will be happy to get back to you. So the first question today is from Liza B. And the question is, why would you choose pellets over injections or creams? That's a great question. There's lots of reasons for that. I would say the most important reason is that the pellets will give you a steady state of hormone for several months. For women, it will last about 3 to 4 months. For men, about 4 to 6 months. When you do the creams or the injections, you're on the roller coaster. So when you first take them, you're actually higher than you should be. And then when you're ready to take them again, your levels are bottomed out and you're lower than they should be. The creams, also, many of these creams are not absorbed properly by the body. Up to 45 to 50% of people do not absorb the creams. And the injectables do carry certain risks that the pellets do not, like increased risk for blood clotting, and several other things of that nature. So that's why at Apex we do the pellet therapies. It's a much more steady state hormone, and actually, in that steady state, you have much more health benefits than if you're doing it the other ways. The second question is from Mark F, and it's how long until you notice results? So, with the pellets, you insert them under the skin, and what happens after that is little blood vessels called capillaries form around the pellet and then feed off of that pellet, very similarly to if it came from your own body. It's something we call endocrine mimicry. For that to happen and for it to start hitting your bloodstream, for women, about 3 to 5 days, and in about men, and for men, in about 7 to 10 days. So if you are taking other kinds of hormones already, what we usually recommend is to keep them for that time frame and then stop and then let the pellets take over. Now, to actually start feeling a change, most people within the week will start noticing increased energy, sleeping better. Some of the changes that happen, like increased muscle mass, changes in cholesterol, those can take several months. Sometimes it takes a couple of rounds of pellets to really get the full effect of that. But those effects will last for years. Osteoporosis is another one where the pellets will actually build bone over time, and that will peak up until 3 years and then be maintained at that point. So everything you feel a little bit differently, but the energy and sleep usually comes pretty fast within the first couple of weeks. So the next question is from Linda S, and she asks, she said she's 45 years old. Could she benefit from hormone therapy? The answer is yes. What we would first do is get some blood work and see what your hormone levels are. As a 45-year-old female, if you are not menopausal yet, you could still benefit from testosterone therapy. Most people don't realize that women make testosterone, but what they really don't realize is that testosterone is the major hormone in women. Women actually make 3 to 5 times more testosterone than estrogen or progesterone. Women start losing that testosterone at about 25 years old and have lost about half of it by the age of 40, where for men, we start losing it in our later 30s, early 40s, and only lose it by about 1 to 3% per year. So if you are not menopausal, you could certainly benefit from testosterone if your numbers are low, and that will actually get rid of a lot of your symptoms, including brain fog, night sweats, decreased energy, decreased exercise capacity, tons of benefits. Now, at 45, some women are actually menopausal as well, and if that's the case, then adding some estrogen or progesterone would be advised. Obviously, the blood levels would show that, and also if you're still having your menstrual cycles, would let us know that as well. So yes, you would definitely benefit from hormone therapy. It just depends on what's needed. Also, when we draw your blood, we test things like your thyroid and your vitamin levels and see if any of that needs to be treated as well. All right, our last question today is from Danielle R. And the question is one that we get a lot, and it's will the pellets cause cancer? And the answer to that is no. So hormones, when properly optimized, are actually protective for many kinds of cancers. They also help prevent heart attack, stroke, diabetes, Alzheimer's disease. So they do have tons of benefit. There was a study done about 20 years ago called the World Health Initiative, which was stopped because they said the hormones were causing cancer. About a year and a half after that, though, they retracted most of that. The other thing that they were using at the time was they were using synthetic hormones. So for the female estrogen, they were actually using a pregnant horse urine, and for the progesterone, they were using a synthetic progesterone, which actually does increase the risk of breast cancer. The only thing I will say as far as potential cancer risk is that if you are on estrogen therapy and you still have your uterus intact, we do put you on progesterone because unopposed estrogen will keep building up your uterine lining, and that does have the potential for cancer. But as long as you are taking the progesterone and the estrogen and everything is good, there is no increased risk at all. So those are the questions for today. Again, if you do have any other questions, ask us on social media. Please like our social media. Facebook is Apex Center for Regenerative Medicine, Instagram at RegenerateNJ, and like our YouTube page at Apex Center for Regenerative Medicine. Next week's topic will be ultrasound guided procedures, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Have a great weekend, and don't operate, regenerate.